Let us talk about capacitors today. The concept of the capacitor or condenser we are going to deal with. Capacitor has a symbol with two parallel lines as shown here. It consists of two charge conductors separated by a distance. It stores charges. V is the work done to carry a unit positive charge from plate 2 to 1 against field, and V is proportional to Q. So the amount of charge Q is plus Q is equal to minus Q. So we have the capacitance C is equal to Q upon V. And the SI unit of C is farad F. 1 farad is equal to 1 coulomb per 1 volt. Dimensional formula M minus 1 L minus 2 T 4 A 2. The commonly used units are 1 microfarad is 10 is to minus 6 farad, 1 nanofarad is 10 is to minus 9 farad, 1 picofarad is 10 is to minus 12 farad. Now let us see what is the concept or the principle of capacitor. The plate, this is the plate P1 which is charged. The moment we bring another plate P2, it gets induced with a negative charge, and now when we have the capacitance C is equal to Q upon V, where V is the potential difference. We will now ground the second plate P2. Then the potential becomes V minus V1, so the capacitance becomes C2 is equal to Q upon V minus V1. So we see that C2 is greater than C1. So just by keeping up another plate in front of another conductor, the capacity of the conductor increases just by placing that conductor in front of it and connecting it to earth. So this is the principle or the concept of the capacitor. Now let us take such a capacitors and connect them in series. We know that C is equal to Q by V. The potential difference V1, V2, V3 adds up to V. The current is the same. So we have V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. We substitute the value Q upon Cs is equal to Q upon C1 plus Q upon C2 plus Q upon C3. So we have Q getting cancelled since the current is same. Q is also same. So 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3. If there are n capacitors, equivalent capacitance, 1 upon C equivalent is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon Cn. So, if C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C2 is equal to Cn, then we have 1 upon C equivalent is equal to n upon Cn. Now, let us connect these capacitors in parallel. So, when they are connected in parallel, the current is divided. So, we have I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So, that is I is Q by T. So, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. We substitute CPV is equal to C1V plus C2V plus C3V. V gets cancelled. CP is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Now, if there are n capacitors, equivalent capacitance, C equivalent is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3 up to Cn. Now, if C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 is equal to Cn, then C equivalent is equal to n into Cn. Now, let us talk about the different types of capacitors. The parallel plate capacitor, the spherical capacitor, and the cylindrical capacitors. Now, at present, we are going to deal with capacitance of a parallel plate. These are different types of capacitors. And this without dielectric medium between the plates. E vector is the electric field between the two plates. The first plate is insulated by paper or air or mica or glass. The second one is grounded. So, we have Q charge, A is area of each plate, E is the electric field, E is the distance between the plates, sigma is the surface charge density. Then in the outer region, we have E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught minus sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, that is equal to 0. This is already derived in while doing the application of Gauss theorem. In the outer region, we have 0, but in the inner region, we have the net field is equal to E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon plus 2 upon 2 epsilon, that is equal to sigma upon epsilon, that is Q upon A epsilon. The direction of E is from positive to negative. Now, we have V is equal to E into D. So, we substitute for E, that is V is equal to Q D upon A epsilon naught. So C is equal to Q by V. So we substitute for V. We get Q. Q gets cancelled over here. And we get C is equal to A epsilon naught upon D if there is no dielectric medium between the plates. Now let us put the dielectric in between the plates. So we have a dielectric. The field here is in the reverse direction. That is the EP vector due to the dielectric. This is the two plates with plus Q and minus Q charges. There's an electric field outside. D is the distance between the two plates. T is the thickness of the dielectric. So we have this as the dielectric slab. Minus QP plus QP are the charges on the dielectric. Then we have the net electric field E vector is equal to E naught vector minus EP vector. EP is for the dielectric. So that is equal to E naught by K. So we have K is equal to E naught upon E naught minus EP. K is a dielectric constant. E vector. We can write E naught as sigma upon epsilon naught. EP vector as sigma P upon epsilon naught. When we minus it, we get the sigma is Q by A. We have to substitute here. And ultimately we get since V is equal to E naught into D minus T plus ET, what we can do is we can substitute it here and V is equal to E naught D minus T plus E naught by K into T. So we get ultimately V is equal to Q upon A epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K. Now we take our equation of case 1, C is equal to Q by V, our famous formula. We substitute for V, Q upon A epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K, Q gets cancelled. So we get C is equal to A epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K. Now if the whole distance is covered with a dielectric, so T is equal to D. So the dielectric occupies a full space. So C is equal to A K epsilon naught upon D. If C naught is the capacitance, when there is no dielectric, A epsilon naught D by D is equal to C naught. So C is equal to C naught K. So K is equal to C upon C naught. Now let us take the second case, wherein if the capacitor is filled with n dielectric slabs of thickness T1, T2 up to Tn, then the equivalent capacitance of this n capacitors connected in series C is equal to A epsilon naught T1 by K1 plus T2 by K2 up to Tn by Kn. Now let us take the third one, wherein all are connected in parallel. So C is equal to epsilon naught by D, A1 K1 plus A2 K2 up to An Kn. If A1 is equal to A2 is equal to An is equal to A upon N, then C is equal to A epsilon naught upon Dn into K1 plus K2 up to Kn. Now if it is filled with a conducting slab, for a conductor, K is equal to infinity. So C is equal to A epsilon naught D minus T plus T by K. So C is equal to A epsilon naught D minus T. So ultimately we get D C naught upon D minus T. C is greater than C naught. So the capacitance is increased by a factor of D upon D minus T if the slab is a conducting one between the two plates. Now let us see the energy stored in a capacitor. So we have first charged the capacitor with the power supply. So the during charging, Q be the charge on the capacitor when V is the potential difference across the plate. The small amount of work done, dW, is equal to V dQ, that is Q by C into dQ. Total work done to transfer the charge is of W is equal to integral dW, that is integral 0 to Q, V dQ, that is 1 upon C, integral Q dQ 0 to Q. So W is equal to 1 upon C, Q square upon 2 dQ. So that is equal to half Q square upon C. Since Q is equal to CV, W comes out to be half CV square or equal to half QV also. Thank you.